Hello everyone, my name is Ryan Phillips. I'm currently a program manager within Microsoft Office. I graduated last May with my master's in computer science from the University of Oklahoma, where I was a University Innovation Fellow. One of the things I get asked almost on a daily basis working at Microsoft is how do I or how does anyone get a job at such a top tech company? That gets over a million resumes every single year, but accepts less than 5% of those resumes. And there's one simple answer to that question. You have to be passionate and love what you do. No one says it better than Steve Jobs when he says the only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. I and others at Microsoft absolutely believe this to be true. The story about how I found my passion starts with my best friend named Joe. Joe spent the first 14 years of his life growing up in the backcountry of China, a village of about 100 people with no running water, no electricity, and not even cars to the neighboring village. This radically changed when him and his family decided to move to Oklahoma after he graduated 8th grade. You can imagine just how hard this was, as he had only taken Chinese and math through 8th grade in school. Even worse, his parents were working 12 to 14 hours a day just to keep the rent for us. I met Joe as part of an iPhone programming group where we were working to create an iPhone application for our startup called Siren. Joe was the lead networking programmer on the application, and as that, we would meet every Tuesday at Chick-fil-A. The first few weeks, Joe and I just spent time talking about how features were progressing or how the app was developing. But after a few weeks, it became very clear that Joe had never felt a part of any group since moving to the United States. This made things like applying for jobs out of college even tougher for him, let alone getting a job at one of his dream companies, such as Microsoft. So we worked hundreds of practice problems over the next few months just in preparation for his interview. Long story short, Joe killed the interview, got the job, and is still working at Microsoft today on an iPhone project within Microsoft Office that's set to impact millions of people over the next few weeks. And even better, he makes enough money to support his family back home so that they're not working 12 to 14 hours a day. What I never realized until later is how much of an impact this story had on myself, as well as Joe. It helped me identify exactly what my passion is. Maybe it's not something that my parents like, or maybe it's not even something I was good at, but it was something deep down that I truly loved. I carried this through my University Innovation Fellow training, through specifically the landscape canvas, where we map across all of our ecosystem out of Oklahoma and identify where the gaps are. And we noticed that even though we had some of the top weather centers and research facilities in the entire world, we never had a single place for students, faculty, or community members to come and explore lots of different areas of interest. And so the fellows built the Innovation Hub at the University of Oklahoma, a 25,000 square foot maker space, doer space directly in the center of campus that allows students and faculty from every major and every campus to come work together. I've carried this on to Microsoft, working with a garage, a space that has 30 locations on 5 different continents across the globe to help my internal people at Microsoft explore different things without the fear of failure or getting a bad review. What I realized truly is that you have to treat finding your passion just like you would any other startup. Continuing to iterate and try different things until you truly deep down know you've done something right and something that you love. So I ask you today, how might we create spaces that allow students to explore, to find their passion, without a fear of failure? Thank you.